This is Professor Satish Uri from Civil Engineering Department. Today we are going to see the experiment on nozzle meter. So this experiment is a part of fluid mechanics lab for the first semester civil engineering students as per the video syllabus. So what is a nozzle meter? So nozzle meter is nothing but it's a device used to measure the flow rate in the pipe. So the aim of the experiment is to find the CD value, or you can say you are calibrating the instrument. In some manner they are called it as a calibration of nozzle meter, in some they are called it as a CD. So CD is nothing but it's a coefficient of discharge. So you need to find coefficient of discharge using this formula. So that formula is Q actual versus Q theoretical. Okay. So now what we are going to do over here is, there is an observation which has been given, like D1 is equal to 2.5 cm, D2 is equal to 1.65 cm. So you need to fill this stagger column when you conduct an experiment. So you need to take a differential manometer readings with respect to number of three trials. You need to find an HF, you need to find a head loss, then you can find it. You need to take the reading of rise of 10 cm water in a collection tank. So that T you should note down over here. Sorry, it's a note down over here. So that time should be note down over here. You need to find the Q actual, Q theoretical, and you need to find the CD itself. So these are the formulas which are going to use. So head loss equal to H. So that is SM by S minus 1. SM is the specific gravity of mercury, that is 13.65. So S is nothing but specific gravity of water, that is 1 over here. You need to find a Q actual. Q actual is nothing but A into B into H divided by T. So A is 30, B is 30, it's nothing but breadth into length over here. H is the height, that's a 10 cm rise. Okay, so that is a 10 cm rise, this part. T is the time taken, so that is a what there we are going to find it, that you need to have it. So, and you are going to find Q theoretical. So Q theoretical is nothing but A 1 into A2 divided by under root A1 square minus A2 square into under root 2GH. Okay, so by using these two formulas you are going to find the CD value. So CD is equal to Q actual by Q theoretical. And in the next part of the video, what we are going to see is we are going to conduct the experiment and you are going to calculate the values itself. So thank you very much. Hi everyone, this is Professor Satish Uri from Civil Engineering Department. So today we are going to carry out the experiment on nozzle meter. So this is a nozzle meter. Okay, this is a nozzle meter which has which is being connected with two differential varying diameter plates over here itself, and it is used to measure flow through pipes. Okay, this is one of the apparatus which tend to measure the flow through pipes. The aim of this experiment is to find out the CD value of this nozzle meter, or you can say your the aim of experiment is to verify, or you can say calibrate the nozzle meter itself. Okay, you are finding out the CD value over here. So what I am going to do is, first I am going to start up the motor. We have got a differential manometer over here. First thing, you need to remove the air bubbles. You can see that there are air bubbles in the system. So what you are going to do is, with the help of some back pressure, giving some little back pressure by closing this port. So you are removing out air bubbles in the system. So when you remove the air bubbles in the system, you close these two ports. You close these two. And you can take the first set of reading of this differential manometer. So here, 8.4, that I'm going to note it down. 8.4. And in the right hand, it is around 10.4. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take the reading, the collection time of the rise of water of 10 cm from that initial point over here. And I am going to note the time, how much time it has taken to raise the water of 10 cm high. So I am going to close this discharge valve. I am going to take the stop. I am going to close this discharge valve. And I am going to mark a point. So here I am going to mark it 7. I have started the stop clock. So with 70, so that becomes a 10 cm rise. So I'm going to note the time. So how much time it has been taken to raise that 10 cm height itself. So when it reaches the 70, I'm going to stop it. So that is around 19.53. ओके, तो राइज ऑफ वॉटर ऑफ 10 सेंटीमीटर. नाउ फॉर द सेकेंड सेट ऑफ रीडिंग व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू डू इज आई एम गोइंग टू वेरी द डिस्चार्ज ओवर हियर. I'm going to vary the discharge over here. Now I'm going to take the differential manometer reading. So differential manometer reading, the differential manometer reading, here it is reading around 8.5 over here. In the right limb it is reading around 10.1. Now again what I'm going to do is I'm going to in the correction time I'm going to to check up how much time it is taken to raise check the time how much time it is taking to raise a 10 centimeter height in this collection time. So I'm going to close the discharge hole. I'm going to fix a predetermined point here. I'm going to fix it 9 over here. I'm going to start when the bubble reaches 9, that piezometer. So 9 plus 10 is 19. So I'm going to wait till this piezometer bubble rises to a height of 19. Okay. I'm going to stop my stopwatch. Okay. So that is around 20.53. Okay. So in similar fashion, all I'm going to do is I'm going to vary the discharge over here. I'm going to take the differential manometer reading. I'm going to take the collection tank reading with a rise of 10 centimeters. So in this way, you need to calculate or you need to get the nozzle meter reading. Okay. And you need to find out the CD value. So thank you very much. Now we'll see the calculation part of nozzle meter. So this is an data sheet with venturi meter, orifice meter and nozzle meter. So we will see only with respect to a nozzle meter itself. So diameter of inner pipe of nozzle meter that has been represented in terms of dn, so it is of 25 mm. So inner diameter of nozzle meter it is represented as small dn, so it is 16.5 mm itself. Okay. So now you can see that you need to have a data sheet of the rise of 10 centimeter water level, the time taken to that, okay, how much time it is taking to fill that, the differential manometer reading with the left rim and the right rim, and the same calculation part will continue with as orifice meter, venturi meter and all. You need to calculate the area A1, you need to calculate the area A2. So H, that's an head loss caused by inflow, that is HM by 1000 into 12.6. Okay, Q theoretical you need to calculate, Q actual you need to calculate, and CD equals to what? Q actual by Q theoretical. So we'll go into the terms of calculation part. Okay, so already we have recorded the reading over here. So it shows an differential manometer reading, it will be termed as X. So 3.2 we have got, 2.5 we have got, 1.4 we have got. So with the rise of 10 centimeter water level, you have recorded the time, that is 13.97, 17.35, 22.5, that one we have recorded. So we have already known that the diameter of inlet pipe, the diameter of the nozzle, you know that. Okay. So you need to calculate first the head loss. Okay. So that has been calculated over here. You can see that this one SM is nothing but specific gravity of mercury, that is 13.6. This is the specific gravity of water, that one we have done it. So this is the X value, that which we have taken it from here itself. Okay, next we have calculated the Q actual. Q actual is A into B into H. So A into B is nothing but they have given in the manual length into breadth as 30 meters. So H is nothing but that rise of 10 centimeter height. Okay, so that one, so we can see it here itself. T is the time taken. So you can see this time they have taken it over here in the formula itself. So they have got a value of 644.237 centimeter cube per second.
Next, they go for Q theoretical by using this formula A1 into A2 by A1 square minus A2 square into under root 2 GH. Okay, so here they use that formula and they have got a Q theoretical value itself. So when you get a Q theoretical, you need to find the CD value. So CD equals to what? Q actual by Q theoretical. So they have got a CD value of 0.96. Okay, so approximately they have done it rightly over here. So in this way, you need to calculate for all the trials towards the CD value. Okay, so you need to do that average and you need to put it. So they have done it here itself. Okay, they have taken the average and they have put the values. So in this way, you need to calculate the CD for an nozzle meter itself. So the calculation remains the same as venturi meter, okay, an orifice meter, and then nozzle meter. So thank you very much. This completes the calculation part of nozzle meter.